Hariyom, welcome to this Ola 19. Let us start with a prayer which is very dear to Kalidasa because we are celebrating Kalidasa Dinam today. Vagaratha viva sampruktau, vagaratha pratipattaye, jagatah pitarau vande, Parvati Parameshwarau. So I bow down to Parvati and Parameshwara, who are as united and as unified, you know, Aikya as the world and its meaning. They can't be severed, they can't be separated. Similarly, Shiva and Shakti cannot be separated at all. And let us now praise Kalidasa. After praising the Jagataha Pitarau, the primordial couple of this world, let us now praise Kalidasa. One of his commentators, there are so many of them. There are 30-35 Sanskrit commentators on Kalidasa's works. We know only of Mallinatha. Okay? There is one more Tikakara commentator who is known as Shri Krishna, and he has praised Kalidasa as this. And because today's topic is dealing with Kalidasa's Shakuntalam, one of his best kritis, I thought this is yet just befitting tribute to the Kavi Kulaguru Kalidasa. He says, Asprishta dosha naliniva drishta, haravaliva grathita gunodyaihi, priyanka paliva vimardharhidya, na kalidasad aparasyavani. There is not a speech or composition like that of Kalidasa which is seen like a lotus. How is the lotus? Asprishta dosha, which is not touched by night. Not touched by night means the lotus is normally bloom during the day. Divakara kiranaihi nalineva, right? And therefore, and dosha is another, it's a pun on every word. Dosha means night, dosha is night, and dosha also means blemishes, lacuna, shortcomings. So there are no shortcomings in Kalidasa's poetry. Okay? Asprishta dosha. Haravaliva grathita gunodyaihi. It's like a string of pearls, you know, embedded various jewels and pearls woven into a thread, guna. And guna also means quality, virtues, poetic guna, kavya guna. So this is like a haravali full of kavya gunas. Then this is vimarda hridya. The more you study Kalidasa, more rasa you can enjoy. And it is Vimarda Hridya. As you know, there is Uru Samvahana that is given in Ayurveda as well as in Kama Shastra. The more you rub your body parts, the more, you know, there is blood circulation and they become very soft, softer. And therefore, Kalidasa's literature becomes more relishable the more you analyze and more you read it. So we are going to have symbolism and suggestion in Shakuntalam. Now before that, because Kalidasa Day, why we ascribe Ashadhasya Prathama Divasa on Meghaduta? Without talking on Meghaduta, at least for 2 slides, I can't go further, right? I mean, nobody can on Kalidasa Day. Now for those who don't know about Kalidasa much, there is a poetic rainbow, you know, a literary rainbow of Kalidasa. There are 7 kritis, there are 3 plays, starting from Malavikaagnimitram, Vikramorvashiyam and Abhijnana Shakuntalam. There are 2 epic poems, Raghukumarav, and 2 lyric poems, Ritu and Meghaduta, Ritu Samhara and Meghaduta. So these are the 7 kritis, like a literary vibgyor, literary, you know, rainbow of Kalidasa. Then we have this, the first impression of the rainy cloud, you know, dashing against the highest peak of Ramagiri mountain where Kalidasa's Yaksha is staying, Ramagiri Ashrameshu, that is the first verse. And the second verse, Nitva Tasmin Katichidabala Viprayukta Sakami, you know. And then Kanakavalaya Brahmsha Rikta Prakoshtaha Ashadhasya Prathama Divase Megham Ashlishta Sanum Vaprakrida Parinatagaja Prekshaneyam Dadarsha. Yaksha saw a gigantic elephant-like black rain-bearing cloud, you know, hitting against the peak of the mountain so that it could rest on the peak for a while. And looking at that cloud, Yaksha got an idea. This cloud is floating towards the northern direction. Can I send my well-being, my tidings through him to my Priya, to my beloved who is there in Alaka Nagari? And that is why, you know, the whole Duta Kavya, the Meghaduta, Megha as a Duta, as a messenger. So this is a cloud messenger basically. And this verse became so popular. In fact, Meghaduta itself is so popular, it has hardly 120 verses. 120 is nothing for the Sanskrit writings. There are hundreds and thousands of verses, you know, in the epic poems. So 120 is very, very less. But every verse is like a gem, okay? And therefore, it's immensely popular. And therefore, critics thought, you know, why not celebrate Ashadha Pratipad as Kalidasa Dinam? So here we are, celebrating the same. Only this much about the this thing. And yeah, there is one more thing, you know, as Kalidasa is sending his message through the cloud, his beloved there, she also sees the cloud. In fact, there is another Duta Kavya. There are hundreds of Duta Kavyas, okay? One more Duta Kavya where the Yakshapatni sends message, return message to Yaksha, okay? And that was translated in English, and it is, the translation goes back to, I think, 3rd century, 2nd century or 3rd century, and it has been translated Sukan. I don't know how to pronounce it, H-S-U. I think H is silent perhaps. So Sukan as translation of Madhyamika school text by Nagarjuna. Nagarjuna was a great Buddhist Nayayika, okay? His translation, this Chinese scholar did. And see what a beautiful poem this is. O floating clouds that swim in heaven above, bear on your wings these words to him I love. Alas, you float along, no heed my pain, and leave me here to love and long in vain. I see other dear ones to their homes return, and for his coming shall I not yearn? Since my Lord left that unhappy day, my mirror's dust has not been brushed away. My heart, like running water, knows no peace, but bleeds and bleeds forever without cease. Such a beautiful poem, you know. So this is like a reply of Yakshapatni to Yaksha, okay? Now, enough of Meghaduta, shall we go to Shakuntalam, the topic of today. Kalidasa wrote three dramas, I told you, Malavika Agnimitram, Vikram Urvashiyam and Abhijnana Shakuntalam. If you look at the heroines in these three dramas, Malavika Agnimitram has Malavika, a princess, a human, Manushi Naika, as the heroine. Vikram Urvashiyam, it is Urvashi, the celestial nymph, Apsaras, as the heroine, and Pururava is a mortal man. So this is something like a mythological motif, you know, a celestial woman marrying a mortal man on certain conditions. So there are also certain conditions for that. And then she is a celestial nymph. And the third thing, third Abhijnana Shakuntalam, Shakuntala is a mixture of divine and human. Her mother is a nymph, Menaka, and the father is a human, Vishwamitra. So this is a combination. And we have this famous poet, German poet, Goethe, or Goethe, however you pronounce him, Goethe. So he remarked, you know, if you want to see heaven meeting the earth, enjoy Shakuntalam. Eki bhutam abhuta purvam athava swarloka bhuloka yoho aishwaryam yadi vanchasi priyasakhe Shakuntalam sevyatam. So just enjoy Shakuntala. Now this Abhijnana Shakuntalam, Abhijnana is something, Abhijnayate anena iti. You can recognize a person through something. It's a token. It's a token. Token could be in the form of a ring, in the form of a bracelet, in the form of a shawl, anything. Okay, it's a token. So now here there is Abhijnanam by which Shakuntala was recognized by Dushyanta, who had forgotten her for a while. Okay, but I feel that there is another recognition. Of course, we can't call it recognition. It is cognition of Sarvadamana, Dushyanta's own son, in the seventh act. I'm not dealing that today, anyhow. So that is Abhijnanam. Now the benedictory verse, how the suggestion starts right from the first verse. This is a very difficult verse. I mean, in Shakuntala is like, you know, very easy that way, I mean language wise. But the first verse is very, very difficult to interpret, to read, to memorize as well. Ya srishtihi srashtu radhya vahati vidhihutam ya haviri ya chohotri ye dve kalam vidhattaha shruti vishaya guna ya sthita vyapya vishvam या माहु सर्व बीज प्रकृतिरिति यया प्राणिनः प्राणवन्तः प्रत्यक्षाभि प्रपन्नस्तनुभिरवतु वः ताभिः अष्टाभिरीशः. सो दिस् इस् अष्टमूर्ति ईश. इन् द राइट कॉर्नर यू कैन सी अष्टमूर्ति ईश. शिव हैज गॉट ईश इज शिव. ही हैज गॉट एट परसेप्टिबल फॉर्म्स प्रत्यक्षाभिः तनुभिः. ही हैज एट बॉडीज, एट फॉर्म्स. एंड वॉट आर दीज एट? They are basically the five gross elements: prithvi, aptej, vayu, akash, sun and moon, and the yajamana, one who sacrifices, the sacrificer. So these are the eight forms of Shiva. Now how they suggest the characters of the play, that is very interesting to see, and it has been given by various commentators in various ways. Okay, so ya srishtihi adya, the first ever creation, it is apa eva sasar jadau. Water principle is the first principle. Okay, but now here in the Shakuntalam, it is Shakuntala, the heroine, who is called to be Adya. You know, she is the first creation, very beautiful. She is the Adya srishtihi. Vidhihutam havihi, it is the fire element in which the oblations are offered. Here it is the Gandharva vivaha of Dushyanta and Shakuntala. Hotri, it is Hotru, basically the sacrificer, because it is Murtihi. These are all the adjectives of Murti, which is a feminine gender, and therefore Hotru becomes Hotri. He is Kanva because he is giving away his daughter, right, as an oblation in the fire. Okay, Ye Dve, these are the Surya Chandra, the timekeepers. Here in the play they are her two great friends, Anasuya and Priyamvada. They have kept the time. How? There is a curse episode in Shakuntalam. Everybody knows about Durvasa's curse. They haven't told her about the curse. They have hidden about that curse. But they know exactly when the Shap will get over. And therefore they tell her, you know, this Anguliyaka, the ring, you have to protect. Then Shruti Vishaya, it is Akasha Tattva, that is Shakuntala's beauty and Shakuntala's fame, which spread all over. Bija Prakriti is Prithivi, basically elemental value is Prithivi, and here it is the motherhood, the concept of motherhood of Shakuntala, because she has given birth to Bharata, on whose name Bharata Varsha is known, one of the Bharatas. Pranavantaha, it is Vayu Tattva, and this refers to Sadaraha Dushyantaha, Sadara Putraha Dushyantaha. Dushyanta coming back to his kingdom in the seventh act along with his wife and along with the son Bharata. So Pranavantaha, that brought back life to the people, because Dushyanta was filled with so much of remorse, you know, after repudiation of Shakuntala. He was, you know, like paschattapadagdha, and all the festivities had come to a halt. Nothing was celebrated in his kingdom because the king is not happy. But now he is bringing back his wife and son, and therefore everywhere there is life and liveliness. Ishaha is Shiva, but here it is Dushyanta. So may Dushyanta protect you all. So that is the first verse of Kalidasa's Shakuntalam. Now Kalidasa is the suggestions. I am not going to speak on everything. I will be picking and choosing only 2-3 motifs, because there is much to talk and 1 hour is too less a time to talk all about. Okay, so but I will refer to why I am referring this Kalidasa as a nature poet, because I have picked some of the motifs from the nature, from the parisara. So black buck, Krishna Saraha, Krishna Mrigaha, Mrigi, the doe, the fawn, the little one, Mrigavatsa, you know, the Mrigapotaka it is called as, Mrigapotaka. So the entire family of a Mriga, that is there around Shakuntala wherever she goes. You can't separate Shakuntala from a deer, okay? And then there is a lion's cub, so all these animals are there from the nature. There are so many birds, there are so many insects. Insects, the black bee is there, Bhramara, right from the first act there is Bhramara. In the fifth act also there is a Bhramara. Then there is a Chakravaka, Mithuna, which is a ruddy goose. Then Swan, Hansa Mithuna is there. Shukakotara has been referred to in the very first act. So parrot, cuckoo, peacock, so many birds and insects are referred to. There are so many flowers. Lotus, for example, Sarasijamanuvidham, Shaivalena, Piramyam. Then mango blossom, Chutamanjari, Bakula, Kurabaka. All these trees, you know, flowers and trees have been mentioned. Creepers like jasmine, Madhavi, Lata Mandapa, okay, for example. So that is mentioned. Then the Vanadevatas, sylvan deities are referred to. And all these are personified. They don't just remain, you know, the natural beings, so to say. They are personified, humanized, and all the human emotions are superimposed on them. And in fact, they are suggestive of many a human emotions, you know. So the pendulum of emotions sometimes, you know. So all that becomes visible through these motifs in the nature. So only three symbols I have picked up. That's a bee, pair of birds, and deer and doe. Okay. So first to start with a bee, symbolism of a bee. In the very first, in the Prastavana, which is called prologue, okay, in there, after Nandi, the fourth verse says, Ishadisha chumbitani brahmarehi sukumarakesara shikhani avatamsayanti dayamana pramadaha shirisha kusumani. The brahmara which sits on the edge of the petal of a flower, okay, it sits there in such a manner that it won't hurt the delicate petals of the flower. Okay, so ishadisha chumbitani, you know, like how can I explain it in English, I don't know, but in a very, you know, not touching and not rooting the feet, you know, firmly in the flower, it just somehow, it just sits on the tip and sucks the nectar from the flower, kesara. And these flowers are worn as Karanakundala by the Pramadaha. So this is the first Ritu Varnana by Sutradhara to Nati. And these flowers and bees are as good as characters in the play, I told you. Shakuntala is mostly likened with a flower, especially lotus many times. And King Dushyanta is identified with a bee. Not here, but the next verse we will come across. And the suggestion here is when the bee sucks the nectar, it is the sucker, the enjoyer. And the flower, the Shakuntala principle, becomes the enjoyed. So there is Bhoktru Bhogya Bhava, okay? Enjoyer and enjoyed. And it's more on a physical plane. It's more on a sensory level, okay? Sensual, sensuous pleasure and all that. And Dushyanta is charmed by the natural beauty. In fact, the first impression which he gets after entering the Kanavashrama, and when he sees these three pretty girls watering the plants, his first impression is, Aho, Madhuramasam Darshanam. How beautiful, charming ladies these are, you know. Asam, not only one. Aho, Madhuram, Asam Darshanam. Now, this is the verse, 23rd verse in the first act. You know the story that, you know, Shakuntala is being troubled, tortured by a bee hovering around her all the time. She's trying to ward it off, but it comes near her ear, near her eyes, near her lips, near her face, you know, and she is not able to ward it off totally. And some of the, one Sakhi, you know, Priyamvada says, jokingly, that why don't you call Dushyanta? He is the king of the country, no? He should be protecting his people, you know? Why are you calling us? She is calling them, please come and help me, know, see how this bee is troubling me. And they say in fun, you know, least knowing that Dushyanta is hiding behind the bushes there. Okay? So this is again that Pataka Sthanaka and all that. Chalapangam drishtim sprishasi, bahushaha vepathumatim. She's trembling because she's annoyed, not because of fear, but she's annoyed. So vepathu, she's trembling. And still her apanga, she's looking here and there and it is touching her ears. Okay? And rahasi akhyaiva svanasi madhu mridu karanantika. So it goes near the ear as if it is murmuring something in her ears, you know, like a lover murmuring sweet nothings into the ears of a beloved. Similarly, this bee is approaching her ear as if it is divulging some secrets to her. Then karam vyadhunvatyaha pibasi rati sarvasva madharam rasa sarvasva madharam vayam tatvan veshad madhukar hataha tvam khalu kriti. You can see the translations. There are various translations of Shakuntalam in all the languages. You can read that. But what is Dushyanta is suggesting is, oh bee, you are really so fortunate. I must say you are fortunate because you can go so near her. Okay? And we are here sitting doing nothing. We are here. For himself he is referring, vayam tatvan veshad. Because I have been just, you know, thinking how in Kanavashrama this beautiful girl is there. I had heard that Kanava is a sannyasi, he is a brahmachari, naishtika brahmachari. How come this beautiful girl is called to be Kanava Duhita? So all that, you know, philosophical deliberations I am just involving myself into without doing any action. And you are acting, tvam khalu kriti, so fie upon me. So that's why he's cursing his own self. So he's apparently very, very jealous of the bee. And he wishes he were a bee. Then again, see the netra chumbana, karna chumbana, adhara chumbana, going nearer, nearer, nearer at every step, increasing intimacy of the bee, you know. Drishtata to dekho uski. Kaminina madharasvadaha suratad atirichyate. Comments our commentator Mallinatha. Kaminina adharasvadaha chumbanam is more charming than actual surata. Okay? Karam vyadhunvatyaha. This is a very clever use, I must say, of a grammatical construction. In Sanskrit, we have a construction called satashashti. Why? Shashti chanadare. There is a sutra. I'm not going into detail of that. But in spite of she trying hard to ward it off, you are approaching near her, not, I mean, disregarding all her efforts. So that is anadara for her. So in spite of she trying hard to ward off. So jealousy and envy and all that, and very clever use of vayam. We are here doing nothing and you are the one who is acting. And a very beautiful, I must say, swabhavokti, a picturesque description. You can visualize the entire picture in front of your eyes. In the fifth act, the bee comes here. You know, bee is a character, I told you. So this was the first act. Okay, fifth act again. Dushyanta is a, what I can say, like bahuvallabhaha rajanaha iti shruyante. Okay, so kings are much married men. Okay, they had many wives. Dushyanta had two wives, Vasumati and there was Hansapadika. So two queens are there. And Vasumati was an elderly queen. Then he married Hansapadika and he was till now, till he saw Shakuntala, he was in deeply love with Hansapadika. In the fifth act, none of the queens of Dushyanta is shown on the stage. Remarkable avoidance of the extra characters who don't take up the plot any further. Okay? So Kalidas has avoided. That mistake he did in the earlier dramas. That's again a different topic of research. Okay? So this Hansapadika, because she feels neglected, all this time Dushyanta was after her like a bee. And now what happened to him? Since he returned from Kanavashrama, he is khoya khoya rehta hai, like, you know, he is not in his usual senses, he is not making love to me like he used to. And then she says, this is a retorting of Dushyanta, very sarcastic verse in that manner. Abhinava madhulo lupahatvam, O Dushyanta, You are abhinava madhulolupaha. You are greedy of newer flower for nectar every day. You are in search of a newer flower like a bee. Abhinava madhu, nectar. Lolupahatvam. Tatha parichumbya chuta manjarim. Once you made love to that chuta manjari, that is the mango blossom, that is she herself. And now, what is he doing? Kamala vasati matra nirvritaha. Now you are happy staying with Kamala. You don't come to me anymore. You have disregarded the chuta manjari, the mango blossom, and you are satisfied with the Kamala. This might refer to Vasumati. Kamala vasati matra nirvrito madhukara vismrito si enam katham. Who could you forget this lady, that is me? How could you forget me? So that is a sarcastic verse for this one, Dushyanta. But that nonetheless, you know, highlights the nature of Dushyanta. He is fickle minded, and wherever there is beauty, his eyes would turn over there, you know. So that is another sarcastic remark, and this is done by none else but his wife. So he was like that. He was, I say, till fifth act, he was like that. Then what changed? Entire thing it changed. You know, we know the story of that when he got that ring back from the fisherman, Dhivara, then all these memories came to him as a flashback. And then, you know, he remembered, oh, my wife had come here, Asanna Prasava, and I just kicked her off. My fortune was there in front of me, and I didn't entertain her. What a blunder I have committed. So he is filled with remorse and all that stuff. And once he got that ring back, all the memories come back to him, and then he's filled with tears and all that. Okay, so that is the symbolism of B. That was Dushyanta till now. We'll come to Murugi and Mruga, because Dushyanta is, you know, graduating slowly from a bee, fickleness of the bee, to the steady love of Krishna Mruga later. Okay, so that Mruga would come at the end. Now Shakuntala is likened to a flower, many times to a lotus. She is, her blooming body covered in bark clothes is, you know, like a flower hidden by patrantaritam pushpam. Patrantarita, and how are these patra? The leaves, they are dried leaves, you know. So the bark garments are dried leaves, and her blossoming youth is like a flower, blooming flower. So blooming flower is full of life, and dry leaf is lifeless. That contrast also heightens, you know, highlights her beauty all the more. She is anagratam pushpam. She is not touched by anybody so far. Okay, she is untouched, anagrata, unsmelt, literally grahana, gra, to smell. So anagratam pushpam. So all these paradoxes, you know, they speak mountains, they speak very great meaning, lofty meaning, that she, here is a girl who is, you know, very tender, delicate as a flower, okay, very fragrant like a flower which can attract many bees, that is also hidden, but yet now, till now, she is anagrata, not touched by anybody. So her virginity, you know, that is highlighted. And this speaks for Shakuntala many times, like when there was a curse, Anasuya and Priyamvada, Shakuntala is unaware of the entire episode. When Durvasa came, and she just thinking, you know, engrossed in the thoughts of Dushyanta, and how, you know, he cursed and went away and all, she doesn't know anything. It is Priyamvada who goes and falls at his feet and asks for a ushapa, and then Dushyanta, Durvasa says that if there is any recognition, abhijnana, the king will remember her, but not till then, he will forget. So, yam chintayansi satatam, you know, so he will forget you. That was the curse. Now, when they come back, these two friends, they are discussing, should we be telling about the curse, etc., to Shakuntala? Then they decide, no, who will water a delicate creeper like Mallika by hot water? Ko nama ushnavudakena navamallikam sinchati. Right? She is like a navamallika. And the shapa, the curse, is like a ushnodaka. We should not be telling her all about it. Then when she is leaving Kanvashrama in the fourth act, she talks to her father and she says, I am like born and grown up here. How will I settle down in a city life? Like a chandana lateva unmoolita. You are uprooting a plant which has grown here and planting it somewhere. Will it grow there? So she herself also compares her with a chandana lata. So many times there is this flower symbolism there. Okay? Then symbolism of duck and swan, the birds I told you. There is a Chakravaka Mithuna and there is a Hamsa Mithuna. Two Mithunas are there. Okay? Mithuna is a pair. The first thing comes in the Act 3. This is on the Nepatya. Act 3, Dushyant and Shakuntala have wedded each other by Gandharva Vivaha. Gandharva Vivaha requires nothing. You agree, I agree, and we are husband and wife. So simple, no? Very simple. Yeah. It is truly Swayamvara. Swayam. Okay? Swayamvara. So they are sitting in Ekanta. And Anasuya and Priyamvada have given them that privacy and they have gone away from there under some or the other pretext. Oh, I have to feed that Mrigapotaka, I have to take care of this, and they leave them, both of them, alone. But now there is a time that Gautami is coming back, because Shakuntala was, you know, suffering from the viraha tapa of Dushyanta, and therefore she needed some coolant, some cooling effect, so chandana, jala and something like that. So Gautami is bringing that. Now somebody should alert Dushyanta and Shakuntala, who are enjoying their privacy there, right? So now, but how could they come and disturb their ekanta? And therefore from the Nepatya, they don't come on the stage, from the Nepatya, behind the curtain, there is a sentence that's in Prakrit, Chakkavaka Vahue Amantehi Saharam Uvatthiya Rani. Chakravaka Vaduke Amantrayasva Sahacharam Upasthita Rajani. Very remarkable use of this Chakravaka Mithuna. There is a poetic concept. There is this Kavya Pratibha, you can say, or Kavikalpana, you can say. Okay? What is the Kavikalpana? This Chakravaka, these are the ruddy goose, the shelduck, what is that? This bird is called something like shelduck or something, Chakravaka. Red color. So they are together all the time, okay? But when night falls, they get separated. They might get separated by patrantarita, just by a leaf of a lotus. One side is Chakravaka, one side is Chakravaka Vadhu. But when night falls, they get separated. This is a kavi kalpana. So now there comes this voice, Chakravaka Vadhuke. Vadhukka, that ka, alparthe kan, that gives, you know, that her innocence and her inexperience. She is not an experienced girl, you know. Like this is her first time encounter with a man as such. For the king, he is a much experienced man, we can say. Bahuvallabhaha rajana. But for her, it is all her first experience. She is navavadhu, and so that's why very bashful and all. So Chakravaka Vadhuke Amantrayasva Sahacharam, it's time to bid goodbye to your Sahachara, to your companion, to your mate. Why? Upasthita Rajani. Night is falling. So Gautami is coming. Better get separated. So Gautami is Rajani. Chakravaka Vadhuka is Shakuntala. And I always, you know, whenever I used to teach this, I used to emphasize on the verb Amantrayasva. The Sanskrit students should never make a mistake between Amantrana and Nimantrana. Invitation, for inviting, we commonly call Amantrana, but Amantrana is goodbye and Nimantrana is invite. So my students, some students still remember, I am giving you Nimantrana Patrika of my marriage, not Amantrana Patrika, like that. So this is a clever use of this poetic belief, Kavikalpana. And this is symbolic of the future separation also. They will be separated in future. That is also symbolized here. And right from the first act, the reader knows that all is not well for Shakuntala, because when Dushyanta comes there, he learns that Kanava has gone to Prabhasa Kshetra. Why? Daivamasyaha pratikulam nivartayitum. Something is wrong in the Jataka of Shakuntala, and therefore to avert that, you know, and to do some pacificatory rituals and all, Kanava has gone to Prabhasa Pattana. So Kanava is not there in the ashrama. So that was another thing which was very, very suggestive. So all's not well. So there has to be some separation here. Okay. I will tell about the theory of Rabindranath Tagore on this. In Act 6, there is the symbolism of swans. I told you, when he gets the ring, Dushyanta gets the ring, he remembers everything all of a sudden, like a flashback, you know. And then he calls his friend Vidushaka and asks him to bring a canvas. He wants to portray something, he wants to paint something. And what he wants to paint? There is a beautiful verse. The full verse will come in the next slide. Here I am having only Saikata Leena Hausa Mithuna. He wants to draw Malini Nadi, you know, on the foothills of Himalaya. There is Malini Nadi is flowing, and on the sandy banks of that Malini, a pair of swans is reclining. Saikata Leena Hausa Mithuna. There are the words like Leena, Nishanna, you know, you will see in the next slide, the full verse when you see. So Leena Hausa Mithuna, there is a pair of Hausa, and this is, you know, like a Uddipana Vibhava, enhancing his Viraha Vedana. Uddipaka, there are, you know, like Sthayi Bhavas, then the Anubhavas, then the Alambana Vibhava, Uddipana Vibhava. So this is the Uddipana Vibhava. Then there are Sanchari Bhavas, all together make a rasa. Vibhava Anubhava Vyabhichari Sanyogat Rasa Nishpattihi Rasa Sutra. So Hausa Mithuna Uddipakatvati Shayaha Vyajjate, that is suggested that his viraha gets more and more enhanced when he sees, even in the animal and the bird kingdom, two people coming together, the mate, the Nara and the Nari, when they come together, he has that, you know, he feels and suffers from the pangs of separation. Okay? So Dushyanta is full of remorse and all that. He realizes that how ill-treated, how you know, unfortunate manner he has treated his pregnant wife, and therefore remembers the good days he spent in the hermitage with her. A pair of swan reclining on the sandy banks of River Malini remind him of Shakuntala's company, which he enjoyed in the third act of Shakuntala, and this all makes him very, very nostalgic. Okay. The verse has to come still, because that is my climax pair, you know, Mriga and Mrigi. So how this Mriga is very dear is dear to Shakuntala in all the manners. So Shakuntala is fond of a fawn, the Mriga Potaka, you know, and it is said that the Mriga Potaka, its mother died at the time of the delivery. The doe died, Harini, the Mrigi died. So the Mriga Potaka was left uncared for. I mean, who would take care of a motherless child, right? And it was she who used to fondle like her own baby. And when that Mriga Potaka first went on grazing, the sharp blades of the grass, they tore apart its tongue, you know, because Darabha or Kusha are very piercing edges they have got. And she did, you know, the ingudi taila. She applied the taila, the ointment, and healed its wound, you know. So like that, she has cared for that fawn, Mriga Potaka. That is the one which won't leave her anywhere. You know, wherever she goes, the fawn will follow her pallu, you know, and it will follow her wherever she went. So this is Udgalita Darbha Kavala Mriga Parityaktan Nartana Mayura. When she is about to leave Kanavashrama in the fourth act, how the nature also responded in a very, like, you know, they are agonized, and in a very full, the ambience is fulfilled pathos, okay, and sorrow. So the Mrigas have left, you know, their Darbha Kavala. They have forgotten to eat Darbha. Parityakta Nartanaha Mayuraha. Mayuras have forgotten how to dance. It was Shakuntala who used to inspire. She is leaving, so परित्यक्त नर्तनाः मयूराः अपसृत पाण्डुपत्राः लताः मुञ्चन्ति अश्रूणि इव एंड लता द क्रीपर्स आर शेडिंग द राइप्ड राइपन्ड लीव्स दैट इज एज इफ दे आर शेडिंग द टीयर्स अपसृत पाण्डुपत्र पाण्डुपत्र द राइप लीव्स ड्राई लीव्स दे विल फॉल एनी वे बट दिस इज टप टप एज इफ द लता इज द क्रीपर्स आर शेडिंग टीयर्स वाई शी इज गोइंग एंड दिस इज अनदर एपिसोड विच शी रिमाइंड्स ऑफ टू दुष्यंत इन द फिफ्थ एक्ट when she comes to the court of Dushyanta and she tells him many things. She tries to figure out the ring and the ring is not there. And then she says, oh, Shakravatare Shachim Vandamanayaha Hastat Prabhrashta Me Anguliyakam. And then he says, oh, you are very smart, you are very clever, you know, and I don't believe in you. You all make some stories, you are cooking up some stories. Then she says, oh, let me tell you something which only you and me know, nobody else knows. Like in Ramayana, we have the episode, okay? When Hanuman went to Sita, and then in the Sundarakanda, he told her many things, but then one thing, that Kaka episode, which was, it's a private thing, you know, between the husband and the wife, and only they would know, third party would not know it. So that also was divulged, and then she believed, oh, this is a true Kapi, a true Hanuman and all that. So something which is known only to you and me, let me remind you, Paurava. And then she says, once while you and I were sitting in the Madhavi Lata Mandapa, okay, in the creeper grove, we were sitting in Ekanta, and there came the Mrigapotaka, her ladla, okay, Chotu. So it came to, and it was very thirsty. So when you offered to offered some water, you know, in the drona made of leaves. You made a vessel like thing out of the leaves, you know, like this, and put some water, and then it did not drink the water from your hand. And when I gave that water, it drank. And then you commented, you know, Paurava, Sarvaha Sagandheshu Vishwasiti Ubhavapi Yuvau Aranyakau. Both of you are foresters, you know, and therefore he knows you better than me. So that is how you had commented. Do you remember that? So this is, you know, Sagandheshu Vishwasiti. On this, some commentator has commented, you know, that why can't we call Kalidas as Gandha Kalidas? Gandha Kalidas. Because he loved this imagery so much. It is so dear and near to one's heart. It can't be, you know, like this close to anybody. Till when it's, you know, the last thing, without telling this, I can't survive, then only it will be divulged. That type of secret it is. And that she told in Bhare Darbar, in the full court, you know. Nobody would like to disclose a secret, right, in that manner. But that also she did, like Nirlajya. So why not call him Gandha Kalidasa? That is one of the opinions. This is the full verse. Karya Saikatalinaha Samithuna स्रोतो वहा मालिनी पादास्ताम अभितो निषण्ण हरिणा गौरी गुरो पावनाः. गौरी गुरु इज हिमालय, गौरी इज पार्वती, हर गुरु हर पिता दैट इज हिमालय. गौरी गुरो हो पावनाः पादाः द फुट हिल्स ऑफ हिमालय. ताम अभितः नियर दैट व्हाट हैपन्स स्रोतो वहा मालिनी. That Sroto Vahamalini Karya, I need to paint. And on the banks, the pair of Hamsa Mithuna is reclining. And Nishanna Harinaha, there are Harinaha Nishannaha. Nishanna, they are also like Vishrambha, fearlessly. They are wandering here and there. Nobody is coming to hunt them there, okay? They are assured that nobody will disturb their privacy there, and they can wander there fearlessly. Nishanna Harinaha Ashakha Lambita Valkalasya Chataror Nirmatu Micham Yadaha Shrunge Krishna Mrigasya Vamanayanam Kandu Yamanam Mrigim. And there I want to paint a tree. On the tree, from the branches of the tree, the dry the bark garments are hanging there, you know, for drying purposes, because you can't squeeze them right? And therefore you come from the river after taking bath and you just put them like hangers, you know, and they would dry because the water would drip down and they will get dried. So under that tree, I want to draw Krishnamriga, okay, a black buck, a black deer, and Shringe Krishnamrigasya, that horned stag, you know, the stag. On that horn of that stag, that Mrigi is scratching her left eye. Shringe Krishnamrigasya Vamanayanam Kanduyamana Mrigim. The Mrigi is trying to scratch her left eye on the sharp horn of the stag. Can you imagine that? If the stag, for a moment, for a fraction of a moment, shakes from his place, just like this or this, the eye will be broken. The eye of the Mrigi will be broken, okay? I mean, she will lose that eye. So the amount of confidence that Mrigi has, that when I'm scratching my eye on the sharp Shringa, she is not afraid that Shringa will pierce my eye. Against something which is harsh, she wants to rub her eye. You know, like the animals you must have seen, at least in the Jungle Book and history and what that other channels, Nature and all, that they scratch their bodies, you know, against the rough trunks of the tree and all that, okay? Similarly, on this rough and very sharp like thing of the horn, she is rubbing her eye, there is some scratch, kanduya. Kandu is scratching. And the mriga is standing there nishchala, without moving a bit, not like this also, okay? So that amount of fidelity, that amount of what you can say, faith is there, that she knows for sure that Mrigi, that he won't move even a bit while I am doing this act. And by the way, Kanduyana is one of the Kriya explained in Kama Shastra Vaivatsyayana that enhances the love, the feeling of love, okay? So this sort of ashrama parisara, he wants to do it. Again, this is so symbolic. This is the sixth act. First act, Dushyanta has come to the ashrama, and the moment he enters from the hustle and bustle of the city life, he has come there, and the first reaction is, Aho Shantamidam Ashrama Padam. How serene, how tranquil, how quiet is this ashrama. Aho Shantamidam Ashrama Padam. And then, you know, his left bahu gets throbs, and there is a belief that when you get throbbing in the left part, something good is going to happen, okay? Something good is going to happen. And then he says, Bhavitavyanam dvarani bhavanti sarvatra. His left arm starts throbbing the moment he enters, and he says, I don't know what's in the store, but definitely something good is happening. And then he sees Shakuntala, okay? Again, when she is about to leave in the fourth act, she asks her father, when will I see you again? O Tata, when will I be able to see you again? And then he says, when you will deliver a son and you will assign him the whole responsibility of the kingdom, then along with your husband, Shante Smin Ashrama Pade, Shante Karishyasi Padam Punarashrame Smin. At that time, for your vanaprastha, you will come here. Not very often. Okay? Married girls did not go very often to her father's, their father's abodes. So, Shante Karishyasi Punaha Padam Punarashrame Smin Chaturthankaha. Then, Swargad Adhikataram Adhikataram Nirvritisthanam. The seventh act also, there is a Maricha Ashrama. There is Kanvashrama in the first act. He wants to portray the Kanvashrama in the sixth act. In the seventh act, the last act, he meets Shakuntala and his son Sarvadamanadhar. That is also ashrama. So the first meeting, union, then separation and the reunion happens in the ashrama. On this theme, I told you that I will refer to Rabindranath Tagore's theory on this. He has propounded a theory that union, separation and reunion happens to be one-liner of Kalidasa's love themes. Now it's up to you to analyze it and apply it, if possible, to all of his plays. So there is a union, then there is separation, and during that separation, it is like, you know, in the Virahagni Tapa, that Viraha Tapa, all the dross is getting burnt. So long it was a physical love, now it transcends and goes to an upper level. And to reach that level, something has to come in between. Like gold, when it is put in fire, then it becomes pure. It becomes purer. So this is a fire testing for everybody, and then the love transcends the physical plane. That is the theory of Rabindranath Tagore. So, Trividham Swarupam Ashramasya, that is a nostalgia smaranaranjanam for him. Then Shringe Krishna Mrigasya Vamanayanam, that was the image. And similar image we have in the third sarga of Kumara Sambhava also. So, thorny horn of the black buck under a tree. And this love is very fearless, and it brings in utmost confidence between both the Nara and the Nari. And similar thing I told you comes in the third sarga of Kumara Sambhavam. Shrungena cha sparsha nimilitakshi mrigi makandu yata krishna saraha. Here the action is reverse. Shrungena cha sparsha nimilitakshi mrigim. Here the Krishnasara, the black buck, is scratching the Nayana, the eye of the Mrigi, and by the touch of that harsh and hard horn of her lover, the Mrigi has closed her eyes in ecstatic bliss. Sparsha nimilitakshim mrigim akandu yata krishnasaraha. Similar image, action is just reverse. And this another thing, you know, like Kitaka or Bhramara, how, you know, I mean, you please read, today I have posted two pager on Facebook, Kalidasa Dinam. So how he treats Dampatya Jeevana, I feel here is the is that principle, you know, the principle which I started with the first verse, Vagartha Viva Sampruktav Vagartha Pratipattaye, the same thing carries on, not only in the humans or not only in the divine plane, but even in the Tiryagyoni, the animal and the beast and the birds and the insects. So this is Madhuk Dvirefaha Kusumai Kapatre Papau Priyam Swamanuvartamanaha. This is the Vasantagamana in the third sarga of Kumara Sambhava, and the entire Tapobhumi turned into Smarabhumi, that's the beautiful description there. And it was spring, so everywhere the flowers are blossoming, and the Brahmaras, the bees, are going around the flowers. This bee, the male bee, is following the female bee wherever she goes, because it's all love in the atmosphere, love in the air. It is Madana who has entered the Tapovana Bhumi, okay? So love is in the air. And from the same cup of flower, both are drinking the nectar. Whenever I read this or whenever I have taught this, I always told, you know, in the 70s and 80s, in that thing, during the marriages, during the weddings, from one like coconut or one gold spot, that time it was gold spot, two straws, and both husband and wife would drink that. If you have seen, you ask your parents, some of the students, okay? So this is like that, the same cup of flower, and they are drinking with two straws, isn't it? So charming an imagery. So true love, again, I mean, wherever the Priya is, the Priya has to be there. And therefore our Yaksha, Meghadutas Yaksha, he wants to be united with his beloved, you know? And because, you know, like Paryut Sukho Bhavati Yat Sukhito Api Jantuho. Okay, I'll start talking on Meghadutta. So this is sync with nature. And how I wanted, I mean, only three motifs I took, right? The bee, the birds, and the mriga. Animal kingdom, the insect, the birds, and the animal. Okay, Tiryagyoni. So from the bee, Dushyanta has graduated to the mriga. So here it was very fickle, from one flower to other, from that to that, that to this, 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 like chanchalatvam. as a bee, okay? And very like physical level, aindriyastara, sharirastara. Now he goes beyond that, and then it is like Hamsa Mithuna enjoying in the company of each other, okay? There is no action of sucking the nectar, okay? As there is the action in the flower and the bee, Hamsa Mithuna just enjoying the company of each other, okay? Reclining fearlessly. So that is the stage, and the third is still more, you know, more deeper emotions are attached to that. That is of the Mriga and the Mrigi. So Kalidasa, now to sum up the whole thing, Kalidasa has tried to idolize the concept of love as such, personification of the inanimate natural phenomena as well as the animate things, and then he speaks of, you know, some sort of inseparable relation between the husband and the wife, the lover and the beloved, as inseparable, as like a samavaya sambandha between the word and the meaning. They can't be ever separated from each other. So vagartha viva sampruktau, vagartha pratipattaye, the verse which I recited in the beginning. And the same is true for his depiction of nature and human beings. In other words, prakriti and purusha. So these are the prakriti tattva and the purusha tattva. They have to be united. You can't think of them in separation. And they are complementing each other, and one is incomplete without the other. So you need the company of each other to be complete. So this is only the three motifs I took for the Shakuntala. If there are any questions, this play of Kalidasa to read in Sanskrit, whose Vyakhyana should we buy, ma'am? Oh, Priya, Vyakhyana, by Vyakhyana, if you mean commentary, I would advise you to read Mallinatha. Mallinatha is very well read, and he explains every word there. Is there any esoteric meaning to all this? This is a very good question, Mayur Gohil. Yes, as I explained in the last slide, perhaps you missed it, it is the Prakriti and Purusha Tattva, or Shiva and Shakti, or Shiva and Parvati Tattva, which I started with the first lecture. I mean the first shloka I started with. So the same meaning, I mean, you should never think it on the exoteric level. You have to go beyond that and reach the esoteric level, Mayur. Please suggest some good books for beginner level learners. Anuradha, I think any translation, especially by Moreshwar Ramchandra Kale, M.R. Kale's English translations, or Devdhar's English translations are good enough to read along with the Sanskrit text. If you are Maharashtrian, Goke Bhatt, Govind Keshav Bhatt, he taught me, and he was such a master teacher, very good teacher. I mean, whatever teaching knacks I have picked up, it is from him. So Goke Bhatt, his translations are good. Please explain the mistake you mentioned by Kalidasa. The characters who don't further the plot, you know, anymore, they should be avoided. That mistake he did in Malavikagnimitram. His queens, you know, like Dharini and Iravati, they come and fight with the hero. I mean, this is so ridiculous, right? So he has avoided that. Madam, could you please explain Kanduyana? Kanduyana Rajeshwari. Kanduyana is scratching, basically, and that is, scratching is like a physical movement, okay? You feel like scratching sometimes, something, some insect bites, you feel like scratching. Scratching sometimes is an act of attracting attention of somebody, okay? Attracting attention of somebody. And sometimes it is, you know, like a kriya in Kama Shastra. Kanduyana is a very different type of kriya, okay? Could you explain the Satashashti concept that you referred to? Gayatri, yeah, this is a grammatical concept, and for example, I would say Rudatyaha Patnyaha Saha Pravrajit, or something like that. You know, the Patni was crying and still not regarding for her, disrespecting that. The person who wanted to leave his samsara and go around, you know, go go away, he just went. So it is Shashti Cha Anadare. That there is a sutra, Shashti Cha Anadare. So I would like to tell you that you search for some grammar tutor who would tell you about Shashti. Okay? Shashti Cha Anadare. Shashti is Sambandha, Shashti is to show disrespect as well. When Dushyanta rejects Shakuntala, is there any metaphor for that feeling? Not exactly, this is Ritvik Koshti, but then he accuses her to be a kaku, you know, and he says the Parabhrita is a kaku because it is again a poetic concept. I don't know, I haven't validated it from any scientist or, you know, ornithologist or so, but the kaku lays her eggs in the crow's nest, and therefore she gets her young ones nurtured by the crow, and therefore you are doing something like that, and I don't know which child you are having in your body, and you are going to have it in me, and you are saying that I am the father of the child. So this is something like a cuckoo, he says. So he accuses her like that. Where do we start to encourage kids to take up what? Literature. And start finding the links between science, policies and Kalidasa's works. DD, I don't know how small or how adult, young ones are your kids. But then I think you start with Amar Chitra Katha. The best is started by Pai. Amar Chitra Katha you start. And then you can graduate to Chinmaya books. There are so many Chinmaya books of stories, okay? And then turn to literature gradually. Kindly explain Trividha. Trividha Paka and speciality of Kalidasa in which Paka? This is by Vivek Solapurkar. Yeah, it is not Trividha, it could be like Chaturvidha, I could say. Yeah, it's a good question I didn't refer to because there are so many things. Kalidasa's entire literature is called as Drakshapaka. Drakshapaka, it's like the grapes and the sugary syrup. Both are sweet. So it's going to be very, very relishable. Okay? Bharavi, who wrote Kirata Arjuniya, his literature is called as Narikela Paka. Narikela, it's coconut barfi. It's coconut barfi, but coconut is very hard to break. It's a hard shell. But once you break it, there is sweet water and sweet malai in it. So Bharavi's words are very hard to break. In fact, the first three sargas of Bharavi's Kirata Arjuniya are called Pashanatraya. Pashanatraya. You are as good as breaking the stones, you know, you sweat out and break the stones, and then you can, you know, arrive at the kernel of the word meaning. So, Narikela Paka. For Magha, Shishupalavadha, it is Amalaki Paka. Amalaki is the Indian gooseberry, Amla. So, it is Amla Paka. Little, you know, like sar or some different taste. I mean, not like as sweet as Draksha, but it's very beneficial. It's arogyadayaka. It's good for your health. So, Kavishu Maghaha, Kavi Kalidasaha. So, best of the poets are only two, Magha and Kalidasa. If you haven't read, your janma is worth. So, so you know, it is Amalaki Paka. It will be good because Magha, you know, pours down his knowledge of all the Shastras. He's Sarva Shastravid. And all that knowledge is revealed through some good shlokas in Shishupalavada. And then we come to Sri Harsha's Naishadhiya Charita, and it is called as Kapithapaka. Kapithapaka, Kapitha is wood apple. Kapithapaka. The smell is not so good. I don't like it. But the paka sometimes tastes good, but it is very, very, I mean, not relished by all alike. So, there are these four pakas, Kapitha Paka. I think its time is running out. There will be more questions. I request you to put down your questions on the YouTube comment box or write to me, okay? And I think we should close. It's 7:10 now. So I'll just close by Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. धन्यवादः।